Oh my goodness, guys, we have frogs in the game now. Hello there, right here. I'm in the Bedrock Edition, and that's why my character looks all weird. But this is edition where they actually added in the new frogs. This is part of the wild update for 1.19, and these can be checked out in game with the beta Bedrock Edition. Frogs can actually naturally be found inside of swamps now. And of course, the frogs do their iconic jumping. They also walk, which looks really funny. It's like kind of like a little waddle. Frogs can also swim. They got a different animation. Their legs are kind of sprawled. And there they go. Looks really cool. Since they are amphibians, they can be just fine in water as well as on land. They're also able to croak. They also chase after and attack baby slimes, the smallest ones, also known as a tiny size. And they instantly kill them. Now you can get the slime ball. And they're actually really fast at it too. This definitely could be used in a farm to kill the tiny slimes after breaking down the big ones. That means coming to a swamp biome, you might just find some slime on the ground from frogs already killing the tiny ones. Now currently there isn't any food for the frogs to like eat or breed with, but they are using seedweed as a placeholder currently. So if you're holding this, they'll walk towards you. And if you right click on two of them, they will breed together. And then they do something kind of similar to turtles, where one of the frogs will go into the water and it will produce some eggs. These are called frog eggs and they're placed on top of the water. They're really thin and they don't have any collision. If you break them with your fist, they'll make this cracking, but they can also naturally crack open and it will produce these tadpoles. And the tadpoles can swim in the water. There's actually two eggs, one that spawns in the frog and one that spawns in the tadpoles. Tadpoles are on land, they'll hop around and they will eventually die, kind of like fish out of water. These tadpoles will grow up into adult frogs, and the color they'll be will be determined on the temperature as well as biome. Killing a frog doesn't produce anything yet, and same for the tadpole. There's the orange frogs that are in the kind of moist biomes. There's the whitish ones that are in the drier biomes, and ones that grow up in cold biomes will be greenish. And you're able to pick up the tadpoles with a bucket of water, so you can transport them to different biomes and place them down again so they turn into different types. YouTube also came out with a special video giving tribute to Minecraft accumulating over 1 trillion views on YouTube. In YouTube video, they show it reaching the 1 trillion mark. Then they have a scene where the players are putting in a music disc into a jukebox and it plays a parody song, which used to be pretty popular back in the day. And the song is a parody of We Built This City. They also show many well-known Minecrafters throughout the years, giving tribute to all the builds and content that got us to 1 trillion views. They even feature this redstone flying machine that Mumbo Jumbo and Grian are riding on top of. They pay tribute to like survival game videos, dream manhunt videos, people playing survival, people playing role-playing. They even show the really old drop game where you just drop straight down and try to avoid obstacles. And at the very end, they kind of show all the different main themes in the distance, all kind of coming together for this really cool ending. Overall, a well put together video by YouTube. And then YouTube also came out with this cool page that kind of shows the history of Minecraft, the different trends throughout the years. As you guys know, I started this Minecraft channel way back in 2008 and actually started playing Minecraft at the very beginning when it came out in 2009. So I've not only seen all the different updates in Minecraft, but also seen all the different trends throughout the years. And in this illustration here, you can easily see which Minecraft trends were popular throughout the years. A really big one is animation, but we also see some newer trends like people playing Minecraft just for 100 days doing something, or Minecraft but where they have Minecraft but then they change a little bit. Survival gameplay is still a big chunk of it throughout the years. They also show the top 50 creators of each Minecraft year going throughout the years, and you can see the cumulative views that Minecraft is acquiring on the right hand side. You can see Yogscast, which is really popular. There's Paul Swords Jr., Sky Does Minecraft, there's also Stampy there, Dan TDM, PewDiePie even doing Minecraft, there's Mumbo Jumbo, people doing speedruns, there's Dream, and even Mr. Beast is doing it, there's Mr. Beast Gaming. A lot of well-known Minecraft content creators. Of course, I'm not on this list, as some of the most viewed videos are some type of modded Minecraft, and I just stick to vanilla survival, but it still brings a lot of traction to the Minecraft overall as a game. There's also this interactive calculator here, which you can type in how many videos you think you watch that are Minecraft related. I'm just going to put in 2,000, then you go ahead and hit calculate, and then it's going to show you like views on Minecraft presented by blocks. So for every block, there's me right there. That's very small. You can see how much other insane amount of videos are out there as well as content. It says this would scroll like this for another 3 solid days. They said if all 1 trillion views just watched for 1 second long, that would add up to over 30,000 years worth of watch time. And if each view was only 1 foot long, it would go all the way to the sun from the Earth with still 7 million miles to spare. Interesting fact that they give down here says it took about 8 years for Minecraft community to accumulate 500 million views, but it only took 2 years to get the other 500 million views. You can see with this chart, view-wise, there has been quite an explosion occurring right around 2019. This probably has to do with a lot of things, including more people are spending time at home and therefore are doing gaming, but also YouTube is reaching bigger audiences like India. I'm curious, of the 1 trillion views, how many of those are actually come from people watching my videos? You can find this stat in my About page, where it also has my other social links like Discord, Twitter, PayPal, Twitch, Patreon, and Reddit. It also says when I started my YouTube channel. So if we take 1 trillion, which is a lot of zeros, and we subtract it from my views, we take that number divided by 1 trillion, and if we hit enter, then we minus that from 1, you can see it's a very small fraction. Some really cool stats there. By the way, if you guys haven't already subscribed, doing so will help me increase my views. YouTube also put in a custom Minecraft animation for their Minecraft homepage. And when you hover over top of it, it says YouTube celebrates 1 trillion views on Minecraft content. Minecraft came out with their own article giving tribute to their 1 trillion views on YouTube. They thank everybody for reaching this crazy milestone. They thank all the content creators as well as people that view these videos of all sorts, from tutorials, builds, to mods, and so much more. They also have a short video. In the video, it gives a brief history of all the different kind of genres and things that people built and showed on YouTube. Some are different types of mods. Explain that the creativity and goals within the game are completely up to the player. There's one part where they talk about redstone that I thought was pretty funny.
That looks dangerous.
It's redstone. Of course it's dangerous.
Watch out!
There's some other funny moments, like this player here using a water bucket to break their fall. They show the recreation of the marbles playing piano, but in Minecraft. YoCast with their famous digging song. There's also Filza running through, and there's baby zombie, a spider, and a creeper chasing after him, which are all things that killed him in his famous 5-year-old hardcore Minecraft world. There's also the famous roller coasters that people used to make. There's a sign that says recruiting for SMP, which was the kind of thing back in the day people would put down signs on other servers asking them to join their server. There's a sign that said speedrunner Xing, meaning that they're walking across this area. There's a person over here that actually is saving their world, and notice how it has a percentage sign there, as if they're lagging and then they have to load and then all of a sudden they continue falling. Of course, there's the infamous nether portal where people don't put in the corners. In the distance, we see a player kind of like riding a dolphin, which is something that people wanted, but they never added. And in the very distance, we see the Farlands, which is something funny you could go visit in the earlier days of Minecraft. And at the very end, we hear Jeb's voice saying that he can give insight into the early days of Minecraft. Now, Jeb wasn't there at the very beginning, but he has been one of the developers that have been there the longest. I'll have the links to these in the description. Now come join my Twitch live stream, as we'll be testing out the new frogs there. And I stream there every Wednesday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday at 2 p.m. Eastern. Check out this playlist to see how I designed a farm for every item in the game Minecraft, or this playlist about cool tricks and tips you can do in 1-18. Thank you guys all for watching, and I will see you guys in the next one. Bye-bye!